All right. You guys. You freaking guys. Welcome to the school. Good old Professor Hypnotic is coming back at you today. I know it's been a while, but I'm coming back at you today with another Pokemon Sword and Shield video. This is going to revolve around the Isle of Armor. I'm probably going to be uploading a lot of videos over the next couple of days, weeks, months, just because there's so much to dive into with the Isle of Armor. I'm super pumped about the Isle of Armor, but the first video I wanted to make is something that I think some people realize it, but I think overall it's being overlooked. It's a feature that's actually not on the Isle of Armor, but it came along with the update, and it's huge for competitive players. It's huge for people like me, and maybe probably like you, who have Pokemon that you've bred over the years, maybe shinies or competitive Pokemon that are, you know, perfectly EV trained, level 100. They got their IVs, their nature, blah, 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 all of that fun stuff. You see, basically what was going on is historically, you weren't able to use Pokemon from previous games in ranked battles, right? If you want to go out on the ranked battle system and do battles, you have to use Pokemon that were either caught or born in Galar. And that is no more. With this new Isle of Armor update, we have a feature now where we can transfer in Pokemon from older games, and we can bring them to a certain character in the game who will wipe out their moves, give them a special stamp of approval, and then allow you to teach them new moves that they can learn within Galar, and then be used on ranked battles. I'm so pumped because a lot of the Pokemon I have been breeding and catching since the release of Sword and Shield are Pokemon I already have. They're in older games, but I just wasn't allowed to use them in ranked battles. So I've been recreating and regurgitating some of the same Pokemon that I've had for years. Now we don't have to do that. So without any more rambling, let's just jump right into it. We'll do an example and you'll see how this works. Okay, so here we are. We're in my Pokemon home on the Nintendo Switch, and you can see I have a shiny Seadra right here. Shiny Seadra, level 48. I caught this. It was actually a shiny Horsea I caught in Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu. Evolved it up to Seadra. We love shiny Seadra. We love shiny Kingdra even more. It's going to be awesome for competitive battles, especially now with the release of Isle of Armor. Going to be awesome. So here's what I want to do. I want to bring in my Seadra so I can evolve it into Kingdra now that Kingdra is available in the new DLC. And I want to use my shiny Kingdra in ranked battles. Right now, again, this is going to take effect for next season, season 5. We're not quite there yet. That should be beginning of July. So we're still going to have to hold off until season 5 for these Pokemon to be used on the ranked battle system, but we will be able to do it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this Seadra and I am going to simply jump to box. That's right. I got to jump to the box that it's in, and then I got to pick it up and I got to move it over to my copy of Pokemon Shield. We'll just pick a random box. Sure, we'll put it in the G-Max box, even though it doesn't really belong there. All my boxes are messed up anyway and no longer organized. So now that it's in Pokemon Shield, we're going to quit and we're going to save the changes. It's going to say it's got a question mark on it. That's fine. Nobody really cares. It's never going to be able to go back to Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu or Eevee, but again, nobody really cares. We want to use this on ranked battles for Pokemon Sword and Shield. So now let's go jump into Sword and Shield and bring this Seadra to the character who will allow it into ranked battles. Let's check this out. All right, so here we are. We're in my copy of Pokemon Shield now, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna fly to the Battle Tower in Winden. That's where we wanna go. So we're gonna hop on our Corviknight taxi. We're gonna fly over to the Battle Tower in Winden, and then really quickly, I'm gonna go throw my Seadra into my party. As you can see, I've been breeding tons and tons of Fletchlings, trying to hatch a shiny Fletchling for a Talonflame. We want a shiny Gale Wings Talonflame, but that's for another day. Right now, we're working on this Seadra. I believe I put it in this box right here. There it is. We'll move it over to the party. Boom. We'll put it in the back end of the party. Sure, that sounds great. So now let's take this shiny Seadra from Let's Go Pikachu. Now, this is not a Pokemon that was caught or born in the Galar region. Now, as long as your Switch is updated, or your copy of Sword and Shield is updated, I should say, as long as you've got the Isle of Armor and the update and all that, you can come over to this dude right here. This dude is now standing in the Battle Tower in Winden. He wasn't there before. Now he's here since this last update. He's got like this white coat on. He's smiling. He's happy. He's ready to help us with our older Pokemon. So if you click on him, he'll say, "Do you have Pokemon from other regions that you would like to have participate in ranked battles?" Yes, we do. I have tons of them, boatloads of them, truckloads of them. Wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. So then, which Pokemon would you like to have participate in ranked battles? We'll go pick one. We're gonna pick the Seadra right here. will select it. Seedra will need to forget all the moves it knows, which is understandable because Pokemon learn different moves in different generations. So he's got, you know, Seedra's got to be up to date with only Galar moves. So they're gonna wipe him out, and we got to retrain him for moves. But that's not hard. We got the move relearner, we got TMs, we got TRs, we got plenty of ways to get all the new moves back onto Seedra. So Seedra will need to forget all the moves it knows and learn new ones that it can use in ranked battles. Is that okay? Yes. Abso-freaking-lutely. They won't be able to recall any rare moves that they might know. Are you sure you're okay with that? Yes, let's do it. All right, then let the lesson begin. Let the lesson begin. Welcome to the school. Here we go. All right, so now Seedra is all ready for ranked battles. See you again sometime. Let's go check it out. Where's that summary screen? We come down here. Check summary, and now you can see on the screen right down below the webcam, you'll see the shiny logo, you'll see the Let's Go Pikachu logo, because that's the game it came from, and then right next to it is a little kapow symbol, and that is your indicator that it is now good to go for ranked battles in Sword and Shield. So if I want to use a shiny Kingdra in ranked battles next season, I don't have to go Masuda breed or wild encounter hunt or whatever. I don't have to go hunt a brand new shiny just to use in ranked battles. I can use the old ones that I've had for years. I've played every Pokemon game there is, was, and ever will be, and I've got so many Pokemon that I'm now going to be able to just transfer in and continue to use, not just for gameplay, but now we can use them in ranked battles, and it's so huge. This is a huge major quality of life update. I've been wanting something like this for years, and now we have it. Check that out. Now if we go over to the moves, they should be empty or not. Well, that's really interesting. It kept its moves. Maybe it only wipes out moves that, maybe that the text is misleading. I think maybe it only wipes out moves that are illegal in Sword and Shield. Apparently all four of these are still legal in Sword and Shield, so maybe it let them stay, which actually that's pretty convenient. So if the move set transfers over, you don't have to go through the annoying process of relearning. But I'm assuming if it had any old moves that weren't legal in Sword and Shield, it would have axed them. So there we go. There we go. There we go. Shiny Seedra in the Premier Ball. Shiny check, y'all. We got our shiny Seedra. I'll evolve it into a Kingdra. We'll use it next season on the channel. Speaking of the channel, please remember to use the links down in the description below. Follow on Twitch, follow on Twitter. Twitch is where I do all my live streams now. No more live streams on YouTube. I like to do my live streams on Twitch. twitch.tv/hypnotic. My Loptic. Link is down below. Remember to like this video. Please remember to subscribe to the channel if you found this information useful, which if you're like me and you're a competitive battler, it should be useful. But yes, please remember to like, please remember to subscribe. It really does help the channel. I'm so close to 1,000 subscribers. We're at something like 920 some odd subscribers. We're getting so close to 1,000. When I get to 1,000, it's a huge milestone on YouTube. It allows you to submit your channel for monetization. And once that happens, it'll allow me to justify putting even more time and effort into the channel than I currently do now. But yes, please remember to like, remember to subscribe. And until next time, y'all know the deal. Always, always wash your hands when you want to eat, but always keep them dirty enough to see where you come from. I love you guys. Peace.